एंड फर्दर आई एम परस्यूइंग इन लॉ, बैचलर्स ऑफ लॉ. सो आई एम हेयर टू इम्प्रूव माई इंग्लिश एंड टू द फियर आई फील व्हेन आई स्पीक इन फ्रंट ऑफ पीपल. या
I welcome Anshul on behalf of the club. Thank you so much for joining for the meeting. I hope you achieve your objectives. Our next guest is Devashish Jatin Verma. I'd request Jatin to introduce himself.
Good evening, everyone. So basically, my name is Jatin Verma and I hail from nation's capital, New Delhi. And I'm a graduate, I'm a hospitality graduate. I'm from IHM Mumbai. I'm currently in my last year pursuing the hospitality course. And what brings me to the Toastmaster is to fire insight to improve my communication skill and English. And I hope this is a great learning curve and a fantastic platform to improve one's communication skill. Thank you.
Thank you so much, guest Jatin. Our next guest is Mannat Kaur. I would request Mannat to introduce herself. Mannat, can you hear me? Okay, I think there is some connectivity issue, I believe. The next person I would like to invite. Okay, that's Priyanka Gupta. Priyanka, would you like to introduce yourself to the club? Priyanka, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Actually, this is my second guest. I am in this meeting. I was second guest. मैं पहले भी ये meeting ले चुकी हूँ. And I introduce myself. I am Priyanka Gupta and I live in Delhi, in Shastri Nagar. And I am pursuing second year BA program. And I the reason why I joined this Toastmaster club, that is, I really want to increase my public speaking skills. Thank you so much. It's over to you.
Thank you so much. I think now we have Mr. Vivek Dhiman. Vivek, would request you to please introduce yourself.
Hello, everybody. I'm Vivek. And I'm a mechanical engineer by profession. I'm currently working with an leading automotive firm in Manesar. And I've joined, this is my second meeting of Toastmasters event. And I would like to join Toastmasters for improving my public skills. And in corporate, we usually speak only on the corporate topics. So I would like to talk more on different abstract topics. So that is what I'm looking for from this platform. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Vivek, for the introduction. With this, I invite our Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Alok Kujur, to take us through the exciting journey of the language of gestures. Toastmaster Alok Kujur.
Hello. Yes, Toastmaster Alok, you are on.
Am I visible?
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are visible. And you are also audible.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Let me tell you first why I decided to choose it in the language of gestures. We as speakers want to have maximum impact on our audience. We do a lot of research and try to prepare a speech and deliver that speech in as convincingly as possible. But research has shown that the total impact that our message can create through our words is just 7%, while the impact that our voice can create is 38%, while the impact that our body language and gesture can create is 55%. So body language and gestures is very important in how we often tend to ignore this non-verbal part of our communication during online meetings. We focus on our fluency and try to be as grammatically correct as possible, but we neglect this aspect of our communication. So I think it's not always about what we speak, it's equally important how we speak. So I chose this topic, the language of gesture. So now let me ask you something. How many of you have visited any South Indian cities or has any connection to South India? Anyone?
I am from VIT. I am from South and I have studied in South India.
Okay.
Yeah.
What is your name, sir?
Yeah, I am Devashish Pandey. I have studied in the Institute of Technology. Okay.
So Devashish, you might be come across this gesture that South Indian people usually do, the head tilting gesture. So what does this gesture mean?
Is it a yes or no?
Or does it mean something else?
Sometimes it means negligence, and sometimes it means that they are accepting it.
Okay. So it means a lot of different things. It depends on the intensity of the head movement. For example, a more intense head movement like this means that the listener is in complete agreement with the speaker, or slightly less intense head movement, something like this, that we often see in movies when the actress used to tease the actor saying, yes, I know your secret. Or this can have one more possible interpretation. Like when a speaker, listener tries to say to the speaker that, yes, I do not fully agree with you, but out of respect, he just nodded his head. So these are the possible interpretations of the gesture. Similarly, we use a lot of different gestures while speaking. And some gestures, if not used properly or in proper context, especially when we are talking to people of other cultures or when we are in cross-cultural settings, these gestures can have negative impact or opposite effect on the speaker, on the audience. For example, let me show you something. We often use this gesture while speaking. Anyone, what does this gesture mean?
This means nice.
Nice, okay. Anything else?
Looking so pretty.
Yes, you look so beautiful. But in some...
Perfect.
Yes. But in some countries, especially in France, this gesture is used to denote zero, or French people use the gesture to say that you are a big loser. Also, this gesture in some countries, such as in South American countries, people consider the gesture as something obscene and vulgar. An interesting incident happened with Richard Nixon, the former US president, when he was in an official trip to South America in Brazil, to Brazil in the 1950s. He used this gesture while addressing to the Brazil people. He said something like, "You Brazilians are one of the most beautiful people of this planet." So what do you think the Brazil people might have responded with? Richard Nixon, instead of getting appreciation from the audience, was welcomed with a lot of boos. So this is how some common gestures that we use in our day-to-day life can have negative impact on the audience if not used properly or in proper context. So we will be learning more about gestures as we proceed in this meeting. And what a better way to learn than to learn from our very own Toastmasters while they deliver the speech. So without further ado, let's just kickstart this meeting. And this meeting today is divided into three segments. Our first segment is the prepared speech segment. Here, three speakers will be delivering their well-prepared speeches. Our next segment is the table topic segment. In this segment, our table topic master will give specific topics to the audience, and that particular member has to give an impromptu speech on that topic. Our third segment is the most important, the general evaluation segment. Here we'll be getting an overall feedback on our performance during the entire meeting. And to help me conduct all these segments successfully, smoothly, I'll be assisted by our auxiliary role players. We have four auxiliary role players today. First is the timer for our meeting. And the timer for today's meeting is Toastmaster Anand. I would request Toastmaster Anand to please come to the stage and describe his role. Toastmaster Anand, over to you.
Thank you so much. Toastmaster of the day. Just give me a second. Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day. So, just like the hand gestures, we should be coordinated with our verbals, what we are saying out there. We too should have a synchronization with what we are doing and what we are saying with that of time. So I am the timer of the day, and what I'll be looking into is basically the time you'll be taking during the whole course of the meeting as a speaker, during the prepared speeches, when during the table topics, and as an evaluator, whatever your role is. So basically, if your prepared speech is, let's say, of 5 to 7 minutes, so I will show a card, which will show the normal time. This will be the screen which you will be seeing. At the other time, what you will be seeing is, at the minimum time, I will be showing this green card. At the median time, I will be showing, middle time, I will be showing the yellow card, and at the maximum time, I will be showing the red card. So at five minutes, the green card, at 6 minutes, the yellow card, and at 7 minutes, the red card. But yes, you will have a 30 seconds of grace period on both the upper and the lower limit in prepared speeches, but that's not the case in table topics. In table topics, you have to speak at least for a minimum of 1 minute, and you can go up to 2 minutes, and then again 30 seconds of buffer period. And the same goes for the evaluation, if just like the case of prepared speech section. So that's it on my part, and I will come with my report towards the end and handing over the stage back to the TMOD.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anand. Our next role player is the Outbounder for today's meeting, and our counter for today's meeting is Toastmaster Devashish. Toastmaster Devashish, please describe your role.
Thank you, Toastmasters of the day. So greetings to all the Toastmasters and the guests. I am Devashish Pandey, and I am appointed as the counter of the day. So my role is to do the quantitative analysis of the pauses that you take in your speeches, the crutches you use. So the crutches are ours, or many other things that are repeated, or the phrases repeated that you do. So these are the crutches and the repeated phrases that you will be using. So I will be doing the quantitative analysis of that and bringing to you the report in the end. So my advice to you is that whenever you are speaking, don't think much, don't do overthinking, just speak whatever you feel like and be fluent. Know that you're speaking right, and the person in front won't be judging you. They are there to listen to you. You are there to improve, and they are there to improve, right? So all the best to all of you. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmasters Alok.
And Toastmaster Devashish. Our next role player is the language evaluator for our meeting. Our language evaluator is Toastmaster Tito Matthews. I request Toastmaster Tito, please come and describe his role. Over to Toastmaster Tito.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day. As a language evaluator, it's my responsibility to pay close attention to all speakers and listen carefully to the language that they are using. And if any improper language like is used, I'll be taking a note of. I'll be taking care of some of the outstanding words or quotes or saying or thoughts, and I'll be sharing those at the end when I'll be called to do so. Also, as a grammarian, I will be introducing you to the word of the day. The word of the day is serendipity. Now, serendipity means the occurrence and development of events by chance in a happy or beneficial way. In simple words, multiple events happening in your life innate series that leads to something good. For example, you clear your exam, then you suddenly get you get a good job, and then a third event happening. So it's a chain of events happening that leads to something good, and that is called as serendipity. A sentence, a fortunate stroke of serendipity. So with this, I hand over back to the Toastmaster of the day. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tito. Our next role player is the listener for our meeting. And our listener for our meeting is Toastmaster Santosh Devi. Toastmaster Santosh Devi, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Alok. Good evening, everyone. I'm the listener for today's meeting. As a listener, I will note down some tidbits of information from any of the speakers and will be asking the questions during the general evaluation section to see that everyone was paying attention or not. So I request to everyone, please be attentive throughout the meeting. That's all from my side. Over to you, Toastmaster Alok.
Thank you, Toastmaster Santosh. I asked some of our members as to how we as speakers do something on stage that can distract or annoy the audience. So I got some very interesting observations and suggestions which I would like to share with you. Someone said we should not stand with our hands resting on our waist. Someone said we should not stand with our hands in the pocket. Someone also said we should not stand in this position. This is called the fig leaf position. Because I think this position especially looks very timid, as if I'm protecting my family jewels. And especially it is very difficult for the speaker to gesture from this position. For example, I want to show you some facts. How does it feel? It seems as if I'm clashing to the audience, and that's something you would never want to do, right? So moving ahead to our prepared speech segment. Our first speaker is Toastmaster Nishant Dhingra. I would first ask Nishant's speech evaluator, Toastmaster Roli, to please come and describe about Nishant's speech. Toastmaster Roli, over to you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster, for the meeting. Today, Toastmaster Nishant Dhingra will be delivering his level one, project two, which is evaluation and feedback, first speech. The path is effective coaching. The purpose of this project is for Toastmaster Nishant to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply this feedback to a second speech. The purpose of this speech is for him to present a speech and receive feedback from the evaluator, that's me. I'll be presenting my evaluation when the general evaluator calls me during the evaluation segment. I wish Toastmaster Nishant all the very best and request the timer to time Toastmaster Nishant's speech for 5 to 7 minutes. Back to Mr. Toastmaster of the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Roli. When I asked Nishant what, according to him, is more expressive, the eye gesture or the hand gesture, he said our eyes are more expressive because our eyes can say 1,000 words which our hands or mouth cannot say. So do his guys agree with him? Do our eyes say more than our hands or our mouth? We all remember that the eye winking girl, the Priya Warrior, who became internet sensation just with a blink of an eye. So this proved that eye can be more expressive than our hands. So let's hear it out from Nishant Dhingra. His speech title is, I love you and I feel for you. So let's see what Nishant has to say. Over to Nishant.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day. I love you too. Don't worry, because I don't mind dedicating these three magical words to each and every creature around me. Doesn't matter he's a male or a female, human or an animal. And especially animals, I love them a lot. A cow or a dog, a donkey or an owl. One day, while I was on the way to my office, I fell in love with a pig. Yes, this is how much I love living beings. Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and adorable guests. When I was in kindergarten, I had a childhood companion with me. She was love of my life. We used to play together, eat together, and enjoy each and every moment together. She was part of my family, and we were inseparable. She had no mother, and I think that is why I was so special to her. She was a small, sweet, cuddly kitten I named Misty. And I think this is the most beautiful part of childhood, that we don't see anyone as rich or poor, human or animal. We just love. But one day, when I woke up from my school, I found my Misty lying dead in the flower bed of my house, covered with her own pool of blood, with a gash on her throat. Maybe it was a dog, a cruel dog who did this and left her to die. But my love, my Misty was no more with me. I was an innocent kid and I didn't even know what death is. And that broke me up completely because it had separated both of us. A few years later, this incident again came back in my life when my friend Rupinder invited me for lunch and he ordered a dish for me. And as soon as I was about to eat that dish, he told me that it is lamb meat. I froze. I was about to eat something that had lived. On that day, I relived that devastating moment, the day when I lost my Misty. And from that day, whenever I see any animal being killed, being murdered or dead, I see my Misty in them with misty eyes. In fact, in every butcher shop, in every slaughterhouse, in every innocent animal, I see my Misty. I can see the various fears and emotion in their eyes. The fear of being next in the line to be slaughtered. Emotion of losing someone close. But they have no choice. They have to die like my Misty died. And it's not only about butcher shop and slaughterhouses. I met my friend just last week who was wearing a leather jacket. I went to him and commented, "Sexy jacket, brother." "It's camel skin, bro." Camel's skin? At that point of time, I was able to imagine a camel's face on him. A poor camel crying for mercy. A poor camel being skinned for his jacket. Who would have wanted to live more? But we humans never let him live more. According to data collected from WEP, it is estimated that we kill over 77 billion animals each year only for food and rest 139 million for our clothing and accessories. Today, I want to ask you all, and you please ask yourself, that why you have become so cruel, so inhuman, that you don't think twice before killing an innocent being. To all those animals who have been killed and murdered by we human beings, I want to say to them, I'm sorry. I love you, I feel for you, but sorry I was not able to do anything for you. A few like human being died due to coronavirus and the whole world is in distress. I know it's painful, but who is going to take the responsibility of billions that we kill and torture each year? I really don't know how my Misty died, but the death of these billions who cannot speak, who cannot ask for help, who can just feel love and compassion has hit my nerves tight and hard. And today I'm here to speak for those voiceless. Dear Toastmasters, please consider my speech as a request to try and understand that animals are living creatures like us. They also have a family, they also have feelings, they also love, they also express. And why would we ever think of hurting them? Today is the day to start loving them, to start feeling for them. It can be by helping stray animals with food or shelter wherever possible, by avoiding or at least by reducing the intake of non-vegetarian food and the use of leather products, but above all, by raising voice against animal abuse. I know it's not easy, but we have to do it and do it now. We have to do it for every innocent animal like my Misty. Dear Toastmasters, today is the day to be awakened, and today is the day to be a human again. And please don't do it because I'm saying you to do it. Please do it because every animal deserves to be loved and deserves to be respected. Dear Toastmasters, from today, when you see an animal, look him in the eye, feel the compassion and express, I love you and I feel for you, Toastmaster of today.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nishan. Toastmaster Nishant, I can feel your emotion. I too lost my pet recently. So thank you for such wonderful speech. Now it's time to for our next speaker. Our next speaker is Toastmaster Jaya. Before I call Toastmaster Jaya, I would ask Toastmaster Bhavya, her speech evaluator, to spell out Toastmaster Jaya's speech objectives. Over to Toastmaster Bhavya.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Alok. So today, Toastmaster Jaya would be delivering her Level 1 Project 3 research and presentation of Pathway Dynamic Leadership. Her speech title is "The COVID-19 Pandemic Has Changed Education Forever." So the purpose of her speech is for the member to learn and review basic methods and present a well-organized, well-researched speech on any topic. The speech may be humorous, informational, or any style the member chooses. So all the very best to Toastmaster Jaya. Timer, please note the speech duration is 5 to 7 minutes. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster. So when I asked the same question to Toastmaster Jaya, that what causes distraction for the audience? She said that some speakers have the tendency to use frantic hand gestures that causes a lot of distraction for the speakers, the audience. So I asked her for a suggestion that what we can use. She said that we can learn from the news anchors how they use their hand gestures and how they use their hand gestures properly while hosting a debate session or delivering news. So that was some good suggestion from Toastmaster Jaya. So let's invite Toastmaster Jaya. Her speech title is COVID-19 Pandemic Has Changed Education Forever. So let's hear it out from Toastmaster Jaya. Over to Toastmaster Jaya.
Toastmaster Jaya, you are on mute. You will have to mute yourself.
Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, Alok. Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, guests. Today's topic is very close to my heart. The COVID-19 pandemic has changed education forever. Last year, around this time, 19th March 2020, I was in CBSE correction, and all of a sudden I was told, I was the head examiner, that we have to pack our bags. And it was just said that the word pack had come from CBSE, pack everything and just leave, the schools are being closed. So, I came back home, and then from my school, I got to know that we will not be going to school anymore for next few days. Then what next? We were told we have to take classes online. Online? I didn't know what is, like online classes, because I have been for the past 25 years using traditional methods of teaching. So COVID-19 dramatically changed the education, and there was a distinctive rise in e-learning, and the teaching had been taking remotely and on digital platform. If we look into this statistics, the global impact, if we see, we will find that the pandemic forced the schools to close around 1.5 billion students in around 186 countries were out of the classrooms, and they were trying to navigate the education from where? From their home. And it was all of a sudden a new normal. Education changed dramatically. I myself had to figure out, one of my students told me, I didn't know where to take the class. It was suggested take the class on Zoom. Okay, I tried to figure out how to use the technology. Even before COVID-19, there had been a lot of growth in technology. But by the outbreak of the virus, adoption of education technology had been seen, and there was a transition in digital learning. You will see in this slide, myself, I didn't know how to take the classes, and it was my students who were prompting me how to take the class. And a day happened, it was a week or 10 days into the digital teaching, I didn't know how to annotate. And see what happened. I was taking the class. I was coolly writing on the whiteboard, and it was scribbled by someone. Why? Because that time I figured out that I had to use annotation. So slowly and slowly, as a teacher also, I evolved. Then it came that we had to take the exams. Okay, exams. Students were told, keep your videos on, Zoom on, your camera on, this on, and myself, I was trying to invigilate, but the students were very smart enough, and there had been what I found, even right now the annual exams took place, there was rampant cheating. So that was a bad thing about the digital platform, what I found. But yes, there were positive things. And another thing what that I was found in my classes, everyone, no one, if I said that please put your videos on, no one would put their video on. It was me with the video on, and others, it was just like a ghost town in the Zoom platform. Now, in the rural, in the urban India, the teachers and the students had access to the net packs, and they resorted to distance learning and digital learning. But what about rural India? In rural India, the students, they didn't have the luxury to attend the online classes. And if we look into the statistics, we will find that mostly they have the net packs access for social networking, for entertainment, and for online communication. According to a survey that was taken for a 500 students, out of that, it was found only 30 to 40 students were connected to WhatsApp. And in rural India, really they had smartphones. So that is a cause of concern. And also, cause of concern that teachers, they did their bit for the rural India. Teachers, they tried to send voiceover mails and all, because Android phones and all are rarely available for our rural students. The urban students, they have access, they have laptops, they have smartphones, but the rural India, there is a digital gap. But what I find is positive about the digital platform, that nowadays we can take the classes, hybrid classes, blended learning, and in hybrid classes, students don't have to travel. So it is good in a way. So thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jaya, for such an insightful speech. We have another very promising speaker, Toastmaster Abhishi Rathod. I would request Toastmaster Abhishi Rathod, speech evaluator, Toastmaster Santosh, to please come and describe Abhishi's speech objective. Toastmaster Santosh.
Thank you, Toastmaster Alok. Good evening, everyone, once again. Toastmaster Abhishi will be delivering Level 3, Project 1, Negotiate the Best Outcome from Dynamic Leadership Pathway. The purpose of this project is for the member to learn about different types of negotiation and the strategies that can be used when negotiating. The purpose of this speech is for the member to share some aspect of past or future negotiation in her life. The time allotted for the speech, 5 to 7 minutes. I wish all the best to the target speaker. Over to you, Toastmaster Alok.
Thank you, Toastmaster Santosh. Sometimes I'm just imperfectly perfect. Toastmaster Abhishi, over to you.
Human beings are born solitary, but we often see them in groups everywhere, talking to each other, be it bitching, gossiping, or discussing on some important topics. These social interactions can be polite, fun, informative, but also scary, strange, and might lead to heated debates. Sometimes the social interactions become negotiation, where either you or the other person has to compromise. fellow Toastmasters and guests. Negotiation is a discussion which revolves around an issue in which both the parties try to persuade the other person to agree with his point of view. I was wondering, what's my style of negotiation? And to my surprise, I discovered it's not constant. I am part of competitive negotiation every single day. It creates a win-loss situation. Whenever my mother asks me and my brother, what should she make for dinner? I and my brother, we enter into a fight because we have contradictory food choice. My mother asks us to decide in 5 minutes, and that time is very less for us to decide because none of us is ready to compromise. Then my time is over and my mother decides. So she either makes food of my choice or my brother. Another example of competitive negotiation is whenever we go to shopping, we all have habit of bargaining. We go to a shop and if the shopkeeper asks us to pay 320 rupees, we tell him that I always come to your shop. And last time when I came, you asked for 300 rupees. No matter whether we are coming to that shop for the first time, we always have to say this. So I feel it's good to be imperfectly perfect, as I find nothing wrong in fighting to eat food of my choice and stop the shopkeeper to loot me. Second is collaborative style. Whenever I go out, after exams, I always go out with my friends for dinner and we discuss for long about the venue. Then I lead the group and we reach to a final discussion that is not recommended by one person, but decided by all of us. So here, we all friends are imperfectly perfect. And this helps us to enjoy dinner together because none of us is stuck to one venue. We all decided mutually. Third strategy of negotiation is accommodation, in which one party accepts the choice of other to reach the decision, knowing that in past or future, there was or will be a time when their choice will be accepted by the other group. This happens with me in hostel because I and my roommate always like to wash clothes on Sunday. But we have a small balcony and only one of us can wash if we want to dry our clothes. So on even Sundays, I wash my clothes and odd Sundays, my roommate washes clothes. So here, we both are imperfectly perfect as we both get a fair chance to wash clothes on the day we want and we compromise equally. Fourth and the last strategy of negotiation is compromise. So whenever we all love travel, in my family, we all love traveling. So whenever we plan a family trip, me and my brother are on the same side. This happens very less, but yes, we both like to go on adventurous trip where we climb mountains. But my mother is extremely religious and she likes to go to temples. She is big devotee of all gods. And then my dad comes up with the idea of Vaishno Devi as it covers both. We have to climb to the mountain and then once you reach the top, we get a temple. So he leads a decision and neither group can be convinced to adopt others' recommendation. So my dad, being clever, introduces a third choice that is accepted by all of us. And by this, both the groups have to compromise. So here we all are imperfectly perfect as we don't accept our father, as had we not accepted our father's choice, we would have not enjoyed the Vaishno Devi's trip. So there is a difference between collaborative and compromise because in collaborative, people mutually decide and come up to a conclusion. Whereas in compromise, sometimes some third person has to intervene and then make people agree to something that's does not matches with the opinion of the other people. So Toastmasters and guests, we should always try for ideal negotiation, as it is the perfect strategy of negotiation. It paves the way to a win and win solution in which all are granted. But it's not always possible. So depending upon the situation and the people around us, we should adopt different strategies of negotiation, because sometimes being just imperfectly perfect makes us blissful. Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Arichi. And thanks for sharing some tricks on negotiating. Surely this can prove to be handy sometimes. Now we can give feedback to our speakers. I would request everyone to take 45 seconds to give feedback. Timer, please notify when 45 seconds are up.
Toastmaster Didi, just give me a second to share the link in the chat. Toastmaster of the Day, we can move ahead.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anand. When asked Toastmaster Roli the same question, what creates confusion, distraction for the audience? She said that some speakers have the tendency to move from this corner of the stage to that corner, and some have the habit of moving back and forth in the chair while speaking. And that's something I also do quite often. So I decided today that I will not be sitting on my chair. Instead, I'll be do all the talking while standing. So I think it all stems from nervousness. So I asked her for suggestion. She gave two suggestions. First, she said that we should let go of our own inhibitions and assume that we are talking to our friends and not giving a speech. Talking about nervousness, we all feel nervous while giving an impromptu speech. And with Toastmaster Roli's suggestion in mind, I'm sure that our members will be able to handle all the challenges that our Toastmaster, Table Topic Master Roli herself throw at them during the table topic session. So let's find out. Over to Toastmaster Roli.
Thank you so much, Mr. Toastmaster of the meeting. All of the attendees today, I will not be throwing topics at you, so you don't need to worry. But I will be sharing my screen so that you can see the pictures that I have brought for you. When you see the picture, you'll be able to see something that should evoke a particular image in your mind. A story that you would like to share with us. And I hope that while you are doing this and delivering your 2-minute speech, you will be using the gestures and facial expressions and your body language as appropriately as possible to your speech content. Now, I would like to see if there are any members who would like to lead this game for us? Okay, I see Jatin wants to go ahead, and I know that Jatin has already been through this process in the last meeting, so I'm sure that he's aware of what the table topics are all about. So just to remind you, the word of the day is serendipity. The topics will be delivered to you via the images on the screen. Once you see the topic, I'll keep the screen on for about 10 seconds. And after that, the timer will take over. And the timer will be showing the green card at 1 minute, the yellow card at 1 minute and 30 seconds, and the red card will go up at 2 minutes. For table topics, you must speak for at least 1 minute to qualify for the awards that we will have at the end of the meeting. Please make sure that you do not exceed the time than 2 minutes and 30 seconds, because 30 seconds is the only grace period that we allow on the upper side of a table topic speech. So I wish you all the best. Do use the word of the day. Who knows, it might just be a great serendipity for you to achieve an award today. All right, so Jatin, I hope you can see my screen.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now you need to pick one topic. Just tell me the number that you'd like.
Seven.
Seven. All right. So this is your topic, and all the best, Jatin Verma.
Yes, ma'am. To start off, to start off my story, I will take you to my dream where I had. Basically, I was in. Am I audible?
Yes, now you are.
Yeah. So basically, yesterday I had a dream where I was stuck in the valley of Afghanistan in the mountains of Tora Bora. Basically, I was a part of the Al-Qaeda team and battling the US Armed Forces. So it was a great fun for me because we had several activities. It was like an army, a guerrilla warfare. Like, we were trained as per the highest standards of any of the countries. And there was no limit of the ammunition we had. Basically, the supply from Pakistan and Saudi Arabia was enough to counter any of the forces. Though I told my team members never to impose a rule on the locals, but some of the team members didn't listen to me. So we had a proper, basically, discipline procedure for them. And it was a great chance for me to be a part of such an group. Thinking of from a terrorist point of view, I'm serving basically my nation, because every terrorist for a country is a patriotic, and for the enemy, it is the opposition enemy. So yeah, it was a great experience. Last night I had it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jatin. I think we should call you a Toastmaster, because you're all ready to join the club. Thank you for your vivid imagination. Now I'd like to see if there are any other raise of hands. Perhaps we can request Anshul. Anshul, would you like to try? All you need is your imagination. I'll supply the picture.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
This is my first meeting, but I will try.
Definitely. Great. You just have to speak for 1 minute, and the pictures will evoke definitely a story in your mind, I can guarantee. You just need to tell your number.
Four.
Excellent. All right. So this is your picture. You can take a look at it. If you would like to switch on your video, that would be awesome. All right, guest Anshul Dhiman. all yours.
Yes, ma'am. So basically, we have to make a story on.
Okay, I'll share the screen again. This is your picture. You can see the picture of this man who's yes, probably ma'am. Very excited.
Okay.
You can assume what he's excited about, or maybe it reminds you of an exciting event in your life.
Okay. Okay, I'm good to go.
Okay.
So I can see a man who is very excited in the picture, and he's going through a jungle, and where he basically loves to travel, Sorry, ma'am, I can't continue. I will try later.
It's perfectly all right. What do you think this man was doing? Why was he there?
Ma'am, actually, I'm unable to recall the words that I have to use in my story.
I can understand. Make up new ones. Go on, it's okay.
Okay. So basically, he's a blogger. He's a travel blogger, and he's traveling through a jungle, and where he saw a camel, and he started taking picture of camels, and later on he moved forward in his journey towards the jungle, and where later he saw a monkey, and he started playing with the monkey, and he gets excited. He saw his favorite animal, that is elephant, and yeah, this is my story.
Excellent. Very nice. Thank you so much. Now, I've just been informed. I can see some raised hands, but I've also been informed that Priyanka wants to try, even though she hasn't raised her hand right now. So, Priyanka, would you like to try?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay. So, Priyanka, tell me the number that you'd like. 4 and 7 have been taken.
I choose 2.
2. Excellent. Let's see what this is. Okay. You probably recognize the past president and the current president of USA.
Yes.
So.
Make a story between the past president and the current president.
Yeah. You can see their gestures. Maybe that can give you a cue. All the best, Priyanka.
Can I take 1 minute?
One minute is what we give for delivering the speech. You can take 10, 15 seconds.
Can I start now?
Yes, please do.
As we know that Donald Trump, our past American president, 45th position, he captured 45th position of the America president as a president. Nowadays, before a days. A fight between both the president, the upcoming new president, and the last Donald Trump president both are fighting. Donald Trump didn't want to leave the White House, but as he is not a president now, so he should left the position of president. The war, the fight occurs between both of them, that he didn't lose. He himself thought that he is now a president, and when the time was coming for the preamble of the new president, he and his people, who are the party, where they are a party of member of a party, came in the warehouse and fight with each other. It's over to you.
Thank you. That was excellent, Priyanka. That was a very nice attempt. All right. May I call on Mannat now?
Tabletop Master, sorry to inform, but this will be the last speaker.
Yes, definitely. And you don't need to be sorry about it. Thank you. Mannat, would you like to unmute yourself and let me know which topic you'd like, the number?
Ma'am, I'll choose the topic 8.
8. All right, Mannat. You can
I get 15 seconds?
Yeah. Please take it. Thank you. Take your seconds. Yeah. All right, I'm giving the control over to the timer now.
Can I begin now?
Yes, please begin.
Okay. Now, this is a gesture that's very common, and you all might be thinking that I'll be creating a scene wherein I ask my mother to, when my mother asks me to study, or when my mother asks me to study and I give back a gesture like this, or when she tells me to do something that is not to my liking, I give this gesture. But as I have my history exam tomorrow, then maybe I'll be correlating a bit with it. And I'll be going back in time and will be relating this to the national movement time period. So it was the time when the British rule was at its highest, and they were doing all kinds of things to ruin India. And they were ruling India very, very harshly. So all the Indian rulers, Indian moderates and the radicals of that time from the Indian Congress, like Sardar Vallabhai Patel and, okay, maybe I'll digress. I'm not able to create a good story out of this. I'll change my point of view. So basically I'll say it was a warm and a comfortable night. And I was snug as a bug in a rug in my cozy bed when I unknowingly dozed off. And I was in a fairy land with fairies and dwarfs dancing around me, and they were singing melodious songs. So I was sitting under the shade of a tree when a fairy came very close to my ear, and she said, you know what she said? She said, "That's where my pleasant dream broke. The sonorous, grumbling, grating sound of my father, who was fast asleep just beside me, who was snoring like an untamed lion and was ready to attack me anytime." And at that moment, I got up and I gave such kind of a look, saying, scolding him for disturbing my sleep in the middle of the night. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Mannat. All right. Mr. Host, can we have the polls for the wonderful table topic speakers, the vivid imaginers that we had today.
Yes, you can have it.
Thank you. And I'm really sorry, guest Kalpesh. I hope that we'll be able to include you in our table topics next time. All right, audience members, please vote for the one who you think with best. Perhaps a few more people can quickly vote so that they can proceed with the rest of the meeting. I see at least 6 more people to vote. Please go ahead and vote. Okay. All right. I guess we can close the poll now. And Mr. Toastmaster of the meeting, the stage is back to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Roli, for such an amazing table topic session. South India, apart from providing places which abounds in places which are full of natural beauty, where you can find serendipity, it also has many beautiful people who use beautiful gestures like this one. They very often do this gesture. They say, okay, now very often. So this is fine in our India and in some countries, but in some countries and cultures such as in Mediterranean countries like Greece or Italy, this is considered very rude. This is similar to showing the middle finger to someone. So when you are in Italy or Greece, don't ask for a ride showing this gesture. Instead of a ride, you can get a slap. So moving ahead to our next segment, the evaluation segment. I would ask our Toastmaster Karthik to please proceed with the evaluation segment. Over to Toastmaster Karthik.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. I, Karthik Mishra, the general evaluator of the meeting, welcome you all. And this whole, from the starting point of the meeting, the interesting value of knowledge and with respect of topics shared by respective speakers and role players makes us a new learning in serendipity. And I would like to call the respective evaluators to evaluate, to share the evaluation of the respective speakers. Over to evaluator of speaker one.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Karthik. Someone had said that both animals and humans have soul, and the presence of the soul is indicated by the love and loyalty and gratitude that we have for others. And in this, animals always win because they show unconditional love. Toastmaster Nishan has a very beautiful personal story. I could totally relate to that story about Misty. And it became very clear for me as to why he had chosen this topic. It was very emotional, very relatable, and extremely sensitive. We must consider his request. I was happy that the message was very clear. There was a clear-cut call to action with the 3 steps that he outlined, that we should adopt stray animals and reduce the animal abuse and raise the voice against animal abuse. Some of the places, such as the time when he spoke about Misty's untimely death, and when he was shocked about camel skin jacket that his friend was wearing, the pauses were so appropriate. really helped us absorb the shock that he was trying to make us feel. I love the fact that he closed the loop at the end with, I love you and I feel for you. And I was touched when he said, but I couldn't do anything for you. With such a heart-rending story, there were some times when I felt that the pauses went a little too long, making me feel that the flow of the speech was a little halting. For example, when he spoke about children having the same amount of love for animals and humans at that time. And there were other places where probably there was no need for a pause, but he did in any way. Also, I feel that there was a constant frown on Toastmaster Nishant's face, which made me feel that, yes, there is a need for that emotion, but it just never gave me any sense of relief. Now, the eye contact, because we all have a tendency to start looking at our own image on the screen, which breaks the eye contact, and that's something that was there throughout. Now, if only Toastmaster Nishant would focus on that tiny little lens on our devices and just focus on that, only then will the audience behind the camera be able to connect properly. So that's one strong tip that I would want Toastmaster Nishant to consider. I was very happy with the rhythm and meter at times to be awakened, to be human again. Misty-eyed, misty-dyed. That was very nicely done. I hope that Toastmaster Nishant continues to bring such emotionally relevant and sensitive topics with few appropriate pauses. Make sure that the camera angle doesn't allow the hand to go out of the frame. The eye contact is maintained properly. We are in for a treat if he ever chooses to deliver in our club again. Back to you, Mr. General Evaluator.
Thank you. Now I would like to call the evaluator of speaker, Jaya Ganguly. Over to you, Toastmaster Bhavya.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Karthik. The art of teaching is the art of assisting discovery. I love this speech of Toastmaster Jaya and felt it to be so relatable as even I spent the entire year studying online, and all the images she was showing to us, like the online classes with only the teacher's camera on, students scribbling, that felt so relatable to me as I also went through that same phase, but the side was different. I was a student. So I could feel that how a teacher must have felt switching to this medium and what was the entire journey. So Toastmaster Jaya, bring on that journey. It's such a great storytelling skills coupled with examples of pictures that was bang on. I love the start of Toastmaster Jaya's speech, which was very strong and it was very collecting to the audience and grabbing attention, like the voice which she started her speech. So that was amazing. The way her story progressed was great, like how she was working in the checking and they were suddenly told to pack up, and slowly they were told that the schools would be shut down, they will have to switch to online teaching, and then online exams, and learning how to use annotation was great. The story progressed very nicely and she even had very strong dialogues like, online? I don't know what is online teaching. I'm just using traditional methods. So all the dialogues were very emotional and very strong. So kudos on that. I have a few recommendations which the speaker can consider. So the speech was to do research and then present. So what I felt was that the research part could have been increased, like this could have been 80% research and 20% personal story, which was a bit other around this in this speech. So a
little bit of more research added can bring out the speech objectives more beautifully. And what I liked about the speech was that the statistics was shown in the slides, and they were coupled with the sources. So that was amazing. So that research and her story could have been joined together and given a good conclusion in the end that could make the speech more remembering and more impactful if it had a message in the end. So that can be considered. And another recommendation I have for Toastmaster Jaya is on voice modulation. So a few dialogues, like when somebody scribbled on the blackboard, so this could have been said more angrily, and rampant teaching. So these words can have a little more voice modulation, can bring the message beautifully. So overall, it was a good speech with storytelling and visual aid. A little bit of voice modulation and research can make this speech amazing. So over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you. Now I would like to call the evaluator or speaker, Avishi, to Toastmaster Sanju. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Karthik. Good evening once again. Toastmaster Avishi delivered a speech that was entitled as Imperfectly Perfect. What I liked about her speech, the structure of her speech, the body language in which the facial expression and the eye contact. Toastmaster Avishi has started with a nice opening in which she has explained the social interaction and the definition of negotiation. And then she has moved on the four strategy of the negotiation that were comparative, collaborative, accommodation, and the compromise. And lastly, she has given a message that why we should negotiate. So overall, the structure of her speech was really amazing. And in different strategies, she also comprehend the audience with the her own examples. If she could emphasize only one or two style with in more detail by using some dialogue, that could be more impactful. Let me give an example. When she spoke on the collaborative negotiation in which she and her friends were deciding the venue. If she could explain that how they decide the venue in a collaboration manner, if there were some dialogue and the discussion, if she could add, then the audience could understand this kind of negotiation very nicely. Overall, the facial expression of Toastmaster Avishi really commendable. When she was saying that, what is my style of negotiation? So the expression were very nicely used by Toastmaster Avishi. Overall, I loved the speech, and this is only recommendation for Toastmaster Avishi for the further speeches. Over to you, Toastmaster Karthik.
Thank you. Now I would like to call the auxiliary role players who had taken note of very valuable inputs which is needed to be heard. Now let me call timer of today's meeting, Toastmaster Anand.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster. General Evaluator, just give me a second to time myself. Yeah, so it was a meeting where I
can say that most of the people have adhered to the time limits and have taken my words very, very seriously. So first of all, kudos to everyone out there, because as of this moment, with an addition of a speaker, we are still running good on time. So kudos to every person who came on the stage and delivered the way they did. So thank you so much. So at the very beginning itself, I couldn't time myself, but the presiding officer took 5:40. So he was well within the time limit. Toastmaster of the day took 6:03. He too was in the time limit. Timer, which was me, the R counter, the language evaluator, the listener, everybody was within the time limits. All the three speakers, they took so the first speaker, Nishant, took 7:21. Toastmaster Jar took 7:21 again, and Toastmaster Abhishek took 6:12. In the table topics, there were four speakers, and the first three speakers are qualified. That is Toastmaster Jatin Verma, Toastmaster Anshul, and guest Anshul, and Priyanka Gupta. So if I have said you addressed you as Toastmaster, it's probably the reason that you soon are going to become a Toastmaster. So you can congratulate yourself. In the meantime, there were three speech evaluators who have come onto the podium in this virtual platform and done their evaluations. And it's a grayish of a sort of an area where two of the speech evaluators are disqualified. So I will let the general evaluator know who is the person who has qualified in the also on the chat, but it's Toastmaster Santosh Devi, who has taken 2:23. And apart from that, that's it on my part, and back to the general evaluator.
Now let me call the next auxiliary role player, the R counter of today's meeting, Toastmaster Devasish Pandey. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Karthik. So firstly, I would like to state that our counters are something to be improved, and you can't perfect it, but you can improve it in the centripetal of your improvement communication skills. So I would like to start with Anand. So he had one pause, 9 crutches, and 1 repeated phrase in his long speech. Avishi was very natural, but she had 9 crutches and 4 repeated phrases and 0 pause. Toastmasters Jaya had 3 pauses, 9 crutches, and 9 repeated phrases. Toastmasters Nishant had 2 pauses and 0 crutches and 0 repeated phrases, which was the minimum error I encountered. Toastmaster Roli had 2 crutches again, equal to Nishant, which is again a great feat. Mannath had 6 crutches, 2 repeated phrases, which was again a great comeback at the end. Guest Priyanka had 6 crutches and 3 repeated phrases. Guest Jatin had 3 crutches and 2 repeated phrases, and he was very professional in his speech. Toastmaster Tito was very well managed, and he had 4 crutches. Toastmaster Alok had 6 crutches, 3 repeated phrases, and 4 pauses. Toastmaster Santosh had 2 pauses, 9 crutches, and 2 repeated phrases. Toastmaster Karthik was very careful throughout his speech, and he just had 1 crutch. Guest Anshul had 8 crutches. Toastmaster Bhavya had 2 pauses, 3 crutches, and 1 repeated phrase. That's all from my side. Thank you. Back to you, Toastmaster Karthik.
Thank you. Now I would like to call the next auxiliary role player, language evaluator of today's meeting, Toastmaster Tito. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Karthik. I hope I am audible.
Yes, Toastmaster, you are.
Thank you. So the word of the day was serendipity. I am repeating the meaning once again. That is occurrence of or development of events by chance, and it ends in a happy or a beneficial way. Many times things happen in our life which we don't understand the value of it, but later we realize that how beneficial it turned out to be. So, or how good it turned out to be. So the word of the day was used by Alok, Toastmaster Alok Kujur, Toastmaster Karthik Mishra, and Toastmaster Devashish Pandey. And I would request not to restrict the word only to the word of the day, rather use it the entire week so that it gets embedded in your mind. And at the end of the year, you will have at least 50 new words that you will be learning. So some of the improper grammatical usages that I felt was, guest used slowly and slowly I improved. Rather, a better usage could be I improved in a slow and steady manner. The second wrong usage I felt was all have habit of bargaining. Rather, we could use all have the habit of bargaining. The third I felt was this corner of the stage to this. We may use like one corner of the stage to the other. Another was 45th position president. Correct usage may be 45th president. The next was she has moved on the. We may use she moved to the fourth strategies. Some of the good quotes, words or saying that I liked was, Nishant said, I froze, you don't think twice, whole world in distress, raising voice, misty-eyed, misty-dyed. Then Toastmaster Alok used blink of an eye, frantic hand gestures. Toastmaster Jaya used dramatically changed, navigate the education. Then Toastmaster Avishi used human being born in solitary paves the way, imperfectly perfect makes us blissful. So there was so many good usage of words which I've written down. There is not sufficient time. Whatever time I have, I would like to cover. Toastmaster Roli said as appropriately as possible, presence of soul is known by the love one has in their heart. Toastmaster Manat said use the word digress. Fairies dancing around. Toastmaster Bhavya said felt relatable, switching to the medium. And finally, Toastmaster Anand said adhered to the time limit. So even I am adhering to the time limit. Over to the general evaluator.
Toastmaster Tito, are you done?
Yeah, over to the general evaluator. That's it from my side.
Okay, thank you. Now I would like to call the next auxiliary role player who may test our attention to detail. The listener of today's meeting, Toastmaster Santosh, over to you, Santosh.
Thank you, Toastmaster Karthik. I'm here with my questions and anyone can answer. So my first question is, according to Nishant, which gesture is the most important? Anyone?
Hand gestures.
Which one?
Hand gestures. If I'm right.
No.
Eye gesture.
Yeah, right. Okay. What is the favorite body gesture of the South Indian?
The head wobble.
Yeah, sorry?
The head wobble.
Head, tilting of head. Yeah, you are right. Okay, next question is, according to research, how many billions animals being killed for eating?
5.5.
No. Anyone?
77 billion.
Yeah, right. And how many millions animals being killed for clothing? $139 million. Next question is, what was the name of Nishant kitten?
Misty.
Yes, you are right. Fill in the blank. Gestures speak louder than blank.
Word.
Yeah, right. According to research, how much percent is impact created by the body language?
55.
Yes, you're right. Okay. In which country this gesture shows zero?
France.
Yes, you're right. Okay. The next question is the word of the day used by how many times, and also name the members who have used.
I think four.
No.
It has been used probably three times.
Yes.
By Toastmaster Devashish. And I can't recall another.
By Toastmaster Roli.
Yes, you are right. I think it's four times.
Maybe because the language evaluator said that three times. I think Roli, Toastmaster Roli also spoke that.
I think so, but I also maybe I'm not sure. Okay. What is the name? What kind of gap between the rural and the urban India? In Jaya's speech, she mentioned what kind of gap between the rural and the urban India? Timer, please let me know when the time is up because I'm unable to see.
It's been a short time, and I'd like to answer that question that is related to technology.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Anand, I'm unable to hear you.
Technological gap.
Yeah, digital gap.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. What was the recommendation by Roli? What was the first recommendation by Roli to the Nishant for his speech?
That there were too many pauses and he could reduce the pause.
Yeah,
the
effective use of. Yes, you are right. Okay. What were the four strategy? Name of four strategy mentioned by Toastmaster Avishi. Negotiation strategy.
First one was compromising negotiation, and then ideal negotiation. Correct me if I'm wrong. I can recall just two.
No, ideal. These were comparative, collaborative, accommodation, and compromise. These are four strategies. Okay. What was the name of the second speaker speech, Toastmaster Jaya? What was the
COVID-19.
Name?
Education in COVID-19.
COVID-19 pandemic changed in the education.
Yes, you are right. Okay. That's all from my side. Over to you, Toastmaster Karthik.
Thank you, Toastmaster Santosh. I request Techmaster to launch polls for best evaluator. Techmaster.
It's not required.
Okay.
Only one qualified.
Okay, my apologies. I request Techmaster to launch polls for best auxiliary role player. Thank you. I request everyone to please vote. You all have 30 seconds to do so. Okay, thank you, Tech Master. Now, coming to my report as a general evaluator, the meeting started on the exactly time on which is 6:45 p.m. Kudos to Sergeant Arms for starting the meeting on time and saying out all the rules and presentation on time. And now coming to the acting president, Tito Matthew, he handled the rule pretty well and given ample amount of time to the guests to speak out themselves and to make them comfortable. Kudos for that also. And coming to the introductions of auxiliary role players, each and every auxiliary role players had given their introduction in crisp and concise way with respect to the time limit of the introduction. And coming to the speeches and the evaluation, I like the theme, the language of Kester from Teamot Alok Kuju, as well as the topics of the speeches of three speakers was also kind of a complementary with the theme or along with the theme, though there is not much a relation. But still, it was a new learning thing for us, which makes the experience of this meeting in a more learned manner, gives us a serendipity of knowledge. And I like each and every speech, all the three speeches. The table topics, I was happy and as well as surprised that each and every respected guest had given the table topics in quite a comfortable manner. Kudos to the table topic master, Roli Sinha, that she had used innovative idea of presentation and the idea of giving the topic, which makes impromptu speeches in a more imaginative and more improvising manner. And coming to the evaluation of the speeches, the Toastmaster Roli Sinha had given a very concise evaluation with each and every attention her attention to detail as she said it. And I couldn't find anything that I could recommend out of my way to suggest her to try something new, because it was also learning for me how to conduct an evaluation. Now coming to the evaluation of Bhavya, she also followed the rule of commendation. Commendation, according to my point of view, she missed one recommendation that speaker Jaya Ganguly, though she had so much of the content to be presented, in the conclusion section, she couldn't be able to crisp her speech in a more conclusive way, which makes that she wants to express more, but due to time constraints, she limited herself. And coming to the evaluator Santosh, she also had evaluated pretty well, followed the commendation rule. And she was giving the evaluation in a pretty slowly manner. She can speak more, I guess. Now coming to the auxiliary role, the timer Anand, kudos to him that he had did a three roles, being a sergeant arms, timer, as well as tech master. Only recommendation I would like to give him that he should mention the all the respected speaker and role players that who are using the grace time period, because I observe few of the speaker and role players were on the borderline of time limit. And coming to the our counter, Toastmaster Diyoshi, I like his way of expressing all the details of our short list of pauses, long, and the missing things. He expressed effectively and pretty interestingly, which makes us learn a bit more and to be applied for the future meeting. Now coming to the language validator, the word of the day chosen by Toastmaster Tito was pretty useful, and it was applicable, which was the word serendipity, and he mentioned the very necessary things to be applied on. And coming to the listener, her attention to detail was quite well grasped upon and helps us to be aware more. That's it from my meeting. Over to active present, Peter Matthew. That's it from my report. Toastmaster Tito.
Toastmaster Alok, are there a team? You can take it.
My apologies. Over to team Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Alok.
Thank you, Toastmaster Karthik. Earlier we discussed about our gestures that cause distraction to our audience. So the question arises, then how do we do our gesture that seems appropriate and does not cause distraction to our audience? I know I am not an expert in this topic, I'm just a beginner, but I think that we can use three simple tips, which I call the give gesture, the show gesture, and the chop gesture. Let me demonstrate with an example. The give gesture can be used to give facts and options to the audience. The show gesture can be used to show your emotions and your creativity, and your imagination is the limit. We just have to be sure that our message is congruent, our gestures are congruent with our message. We cannot say the profits are rising, right? So the key is creativity plus congruence. Third is the chop gesture. We can use the gesture to show opinions. We can use both hands, or we can use single hand. Both hands can be used to say, to display stronger opinion. Let me just demonstrate with an example. Last week, I attended a seminar on nonverbal communication, and I could feel that my skills are improving. I think that was the best class I've ever taken. I use the three gestures in this sentence: the show gesture, the give gesture. Last week I attended a seminar on nonverbal communication. The give gesture. I could feel that my skills are improving. And the chop gesture. I think this was the best class I have ever taken. I think I made my point here. I know these are things that are very basic and very fundamental, and most of you might already be aware of it. But this is a very good starting point for beginners like us, and slowly we will learn nuances as we attend more meetings in the days to come. So I request every member who are attending or not attending, every guest, and who will be listening to this just recording in the future, I would request all of them to attend all the meetings like this, because these things cannot be learned from grammar books. These things can be learned only when we interact with people in meetings like this. So this is my request to all of you who are listening, to please attend such meetings regularly and improve your nonverbal communication. That's it from my side. Thank you. Over to you, Acting President Toastmaster Abhishi. Over to you.
I'm extremely happy to see Toastmaster Alok playing the role of team mod, because he played this role for the first time and he did a great job. So now I would like the guest to give us feedback. Priyanka, can we have guest Priyanka Gupta? Can you just unmute yourself? Yes. Yeah. So I'll highly appreciate if you could please tell us what you liked the most about our meeting and give us feedback.
The session is amazing. As I told you that the Toastmaster, Delhi One Toastmaster, gave me second chance to as a guest. And I wanted to be a member of this club through the next meeting. And the session is really, really amazing. And I learned a lot of things, like negotiation topic, like you maybe speak. Yeah, you are speaking. You were speaking on the topic. And the other one, the teaching, how the pandemic goes. And how teachers suffer, and the other thing is the first I like body language speak of the session. Thank you. It's over to you.
Okay, great. We would love to see you in our next meeting. Can we have guest Vivek?
So first of all, I would like to thank everybody for this wonderful session. And I believe it is my serendipity that I stumble upon such a brilliant platform where I can polish my skills as well. And everybody is doing a brilliant job. And definitely I'm looking forward to attend the meeting and then finally becoming a member of the club. And I believe that I've attended the last session as well, but this session seems a bit different from the last one. And I believe that this will be the regular session, and I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
This is what happens in a normal Toastmaster meeting. Last one was a special meeting. So we would love to see you in our next meeting. Thank you so much for coming up. I request Techmaster to launch poll for the best speaker and best role player. After that, I'll be taking feedback from the other guest. Everyone, please vote for the best speaker. Timer, please let us know when the time is over. Has everyone voted? Yes. Please vote for the best role player.
There are two more people who need to vote. One more to vote.
Everyone, please vote. Please let us know when the poll ends.
Yes, the poll has ended. You can proceed. Thank you so much.
Okay. Next, can we have Toastmaster Nishant? I would like to know how different was it for you to give speech in DOTM?
I think it's not different because I'm giving the speech in this club for the third time, and it's just like my home club. First of all, I would like to thank Toastmaster Loli and Toastmaster T2 for giving me the speech slot at the very last moment. And I think this is the most beautiful part of this club, that whenever I'm in need of a speech slot, and Delivant Toastmasters is always there. And the cherry on the cake that I got an evaluator like Toastmaster Loli, whose evaluation was even better than my speech. So thank you so much. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to become part of this club. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you so much for coming here. And we would love to see you again giving speech. And we'll try our best to give you Toastmaster Roli as the speech evaluator next time. So can we have our youngest guest, Gavalian Mannath? Mannath, are you there? I think no. So I would like to take feedback from Jatin Verma. Are you there?
Yes, ma'am, I'm there.
Yeah.
So thank you to all for such a wonderful session. I think this is my third session in the DOTM. I think it's the last session for me as a guest, and I'll be member from next time. Definitely looking forward to starting off from the topic of the day was nonverbal communication. I think it's a real big chunk of a personality to have such an incorporation. And I learned such a new nuances like chop gesture and the give gesture, which is completely new to me. And then moving on to the speaker first, Nishant, it was such a treat to watch him speaking. I remember one of my toppers from my school used to deliver a speech just like him, with all the hand gestures and the voice modulation. Then moving on to the speaker too, as hearing from ma'am, such a veteran from the industry of teaching, is really a delight, and knowing her point of view and how students basically entangled with her and her discipline to basically improve the quality of the students. And moving on to speaker three, Vishi is such a delight because I didn't know that there's such a way to negotiate from people. I thought it was just a single way. Bhaiya na aapka na mera. So I thought that was a single way only. So learning these nuances is such a great opportunity to me, and definitely looking forward for next more sessions. Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming up, and we are extremely delighted to see that you learned a lot from our meeting. And if you keep coming here and become a member, you will learn every Friday. So hope to see you again. Again, I would like to ask Mannath, are you there? I think no. So I just request you all to switch on your videos for a group fee. And then we'll take certificates. Please switch on your videos, all the guests. Priyanka.
Nishant, one.
Toastmaster Bela, everyone please switch on your videos just for grouping. Let's make one for Delhi one. It's done. Now I request certificates for the certificates.
Vishy, I'm sharing the screen. Just give me a moment.
I didn't know it's Delhi one. I was confused why this test.
It's Delhi one. Okay. I have been in that situation when I was a guest, so that's why I mentioned it.
Can you see the screen?
Oh, it's coming up. Can any other person see screen? It's just black. Yeah, now we can see.
Okay, thank you. Best, you can proceed.
Okay, so here are,
can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. So here are the awards for meeting 295. Next slide, please.
The best topic speaker award goes to guest Jatin Verma. Congratulations, Jatin. Best speaker goes to congratulations, C.
Santosh, you can
switch
to the next screen.
Yeah, I'm switching. I think my network is so slow. This is not
okay.
You see the screen of best speaker now?
No, table topics is coming.
Oh, moment. Can you see the slide of best auxiliary player?
No, we can see best table topic speaker certificate.
I don't know what's happening. I'm switching the.
Now we can see.
Now visible.
Speaker. Now we can see best speaker.
Okay. Best speaker award goes to Toastmaster Avishi Rathod. Congratulations, Avishi.
Thank you. You can.
We have another best speaker.
You can
see nothing.
You can.
Best speaker. Okay.
Congratulations.
So another best speaker award goes to Toastmaster guest Nishant Chandra.
You can call me a Toastmaster.
Best auxiliary role. Okay. Best Toastmaster guest Devashish. And
congratulations.
And best. Thank you. And the holder award goes to Master Alok Kajur. Congratulations, Alok.
Thank you so much.
That's it.
So, thank you everyone for turning up for the meeting. And we hope all our guests come next time. So here we end our meeting. Good night, everyone. Take care.
Hi, Avishi. I just wanted to request for the recording of this meeting since I am going to deliver this.